Welcome to the series on Azure Migrate, your free migration and modernization platform, which helps you move workloads in a consistent and secure manner to Azure. In this video, we will show you how to lift and shift or rehost your resources to Azure. This approach allows organizations to quickly reduce their data center footprint and achieve immediate cost savings. Our newly designed experience is crafted to guide you through your migration journey in an organized and systematic way. In the migration journey of decide, plan, and execute, we will focus on execute for replication and migration of single or at-scale servers for migration. As a part of Azure Migrate offerings, Azure VM Cloud and Azure Local, formerly Azure Stack HCI, are key components of Microsoft's hybrid cloud strategy. They offer robust capabilities for managing virtual machines and other resources in both the cloud and on-premises. Azure VM Cloud provides seamless VM provisioning, comprehensive monitoring through Azure Monitor, and advanced threat protection via Azure Security Center. On the other hand, Azure Local supports VM provisioning through the Azure Portal, integrates with Azure Monitor and Azure Arc for advanced monitoring, and offers centralized security management with Azure Security Center. These platforms provide the flexibility, scalability, and security needed to meet modern business demands. You can migrate servers in a couple of ways. Azure Migrate offers a comprehensive suite of tools designed to facilitate the migration of various workloads from on-premises environments to the Azure cloud. This includes support for agentless migration for VMware and Hyper-V, and agent-based migration for VMware and physical servers and other public clouds such as AWS and GCP. Agentless migration simplifies the migration process by eliminating the need for agent installation, reducing overhead and potential disruptions to the source environment. Agent-based migration offers a robust solution for migrating complex workloads, ensuring that all necessary configurations and dependencies are replicated accurately. For identifying which approach suits you best, check out our public documentation to identify the differences. Today, we'll walk you through the process of migrating VMware Virtual Machines, VMs, to Azure, without the need for installing agents on the source machines. This method uses the Azure Migrate appliance to discover and replicate VMs, ensuring minimal disruption to your operations. Before starting the agentless migration process, there are a few prerequisites to set up the Azure Migrate project and appliance in your VMware environment. Discover your on-premises inventory and assess VMs for readiness. These steps ensure a smooth and efficient migration by identifying and addressing any potential issues beforehand. Also, make sure to cross-check the vCenter requirements and supported VM versions before you migrate. Once you deploy and configure the Azure Migrate appliance for VMware and complete server discovery, you can start replicating your Windows and Linux servers. As an additional step, you can perform test migrations to a sandbox environment with no impact to production to validate migration. And finally, migrate to Azure. For this demonstration, we have pre-configured the appliance, completed the necessary prerequisites, and are now ready to proceed with server migrations. The overview page displays the discovered servers available for migration. Additionally, workloads from AWS, GCP, and other cloud environments can be discovered for agent-based migrations. The Migration and Modernization page provides a comprehensive overview of all ongoing migration activities. Now, let's proceed with the replication flow. To begin the migration process, you can choose the target destination for migration. In this demonstration, we will migrate servers to Azure Virtual Machines. While Azure Local is also an option, for this demo, we will focus on migrating from a VMware environment to Azure VMs. We have pre-configured a migration plan for the Contoso application. We will select this plan and continue. You also have the option to import assessments to pre-populate configurations. However, for this demonstration, we will manually configure the required settings and proceed with VM selection to initiate the replication process. The replication process transfers data to Azure, which can later be provisioned as an Azure VM. During this step, you can specify the subscription, resource group, virtual network, and subnet where the VM will be deployed. Additionally, it is recommended to perform a test migration in an isolated environment to validate application functionality before proceeding with the full migration. Once the environment selection is complete, you can configure compute settings, storage settings, and disk type selection based on the options like standard or premium for the VM. Tags can also be assigned for organizational tracking, ensuring alignment with company tagging policies. After reviewing the configurations, replication can be initiated. Once the initial replication is complete, all data from the on-premises environment will be transferred to an Azure storage account. The replicated machines will be listed in the Replication Machines section, with new machines in the initial replication in progress stage and ongoing replications in the Delta Sync stage. Machines that have completed replication will be ready for test migration and final migration. Performing a test migration is highly recommended. To do so, navigate to the Replication Machines section to view all machines currently in migration. You can also explore the migration blade on the left to initiate a replication, test migration, or migration later. You can also select one of the VMs from the Replicate page and click Test Migration to proceed. During test migration, you can select the default or another virtual network and complete the test migration. Now we can start with migration of VMs. When you click on Migrate, you will be navigated to the Migrate screen. This is the final step for the migration process. You can choose to shut down the on-prem VM so that there is no data loss. As we pause the VM, all the data will be migrated to Azure VM seamlessly, and you can choose which VMs you want to migrate. You can also choose to select the target OS. This step of migration is known as cutover and involves switching over to the new environment and ensuring that all systems and applications are functioning correctly. For this demo, we are not choosing to shut down the on-prem VM. Once the migration is complete, you will have the VM up and running in Azure. During and post-migration, some practices should be followed, ensuring validation by checking VMs, applications, and system performance for seamless functionality. We focus on monitoring, tracking progress, setting up alerts, and integrating with Azure Management Services. Lastly, documentation captures the entire process, validation results, and key learnings for future reference. This concludes the demo for the Azure Agentless scenario. By following these steps, you can efficiently migrate your VMware vSphere VMs to Azure without installing any agents on the source machines. Thank you for watching this video.